Hello, this is John Moore from the National Weather Service in Jackson, Mississippi. And as part of this series on social media data mining, today we'll cover data mining using the Facebook search bar as a tool. The Facebook search bar is accessible on Facebook.com, but it's not accessible on the Facebook.com business manager site on which we use to manage our business pages, but it is accessible on the Facebook.com site that we use to manage our dummy accounts. So the Facebook.com search bar is located in the top of the screen. It's going to be next to the F. And today I'll go to you a typical search that we use as Facebook.com search for to find social media reports for storm reports. All right, let's just say we're looking for tornado reports in near Hattiesburg, Mississippi, or in Hattiesburg, Mississippi. The first thing we want to do is type in tornado in the search bar and hit enter. All right. And that's going to take us to all reports, but we're going to see a broad range of reports. And it's not just going to say be for Hattiesburg now. But you see on the left, there are several different areas we can filter our results by. Now, we can filter them by who they were posted by. And most of the time, you want to leave this on anyone because we're looking for public reports. And usually, our dummy accounts don't have any friends. We can see reports that are posted in any groups that we're in, and usually, our dummy accounts don't have or on a part of any groups, but the two that we will use are the tag location and the date posted. So let's say I'm looking for a tornado report in Hattiesburg, Mississippi. I want to type in choose location and choose Hattiesburg. And this will take me to the post. So I'll start seeing public posts from tornado reports in Hattiesburg. These are all public posts. Public posts can be videos, text posts, or pictures. And I can click see all to see all public posts. And remember, Facebook ranks these results, so they won't be in chronological order. So they'll be scattered among everything. So we need to further filter these results. And one thing that you can do to filter these results is choose a date when you want to find the report. So I'm going to keep it broad right now and say I'm looking for a tornado report in January of 2017. So I'm clicking on January 2017, and it kind of filters my results even more. And hey, and look, this is something that was taken as the event unfolded of tornado damage. So I'm seeing a picture or video of tornado damage. Let's say I'm looking for photos of strictly photos for tornado damage, and I can further filter my results by using the photo tab on the bars on top. So I can click photos, and once again, you're gonna have to go in and type in Hattiesburg, Mississippi for the geotag location. And for my date, let's choose January of 2017 one more time. And look, we have photos of tornado damage from January 2017 in Hattiesburg. And this particular one is at William Carey University in Hattiesburg. And there are multiple reports, multiple pictures. All right, now let's say we're looking for videos of tornadoes in Hattiesburg in January 2017. We'll click the videos tab. The photos and video tab will be the two main ones that we'll be able to search through. That's going to provide us the most information that we're looking for. So once I select the videos tab, remember every time you have to go in and add the location again. So I'll type in Hattiesburg. And I'm looking for reports in 2017. The videos tab doesn't give you an option to choose a specific month like the photos and the all posts do, but it does give you the option of choosing a particular year. So a rule of thumb is to stick with the post and the photos tab when you're looking for reports if you need to narrow it down further. And also on the videos tab, you can search through live videos. There wouldn't be any live videos ongoing now of tornadoes in Hattiesburg, so we didn't find any reports. episodes wouldn't be a good thing to search. These accounts usually don't have any friends or group, but it'll be good to use if you have a public account or you have your personal account with a bunch of friends in that area. Or you can search for videos from links in that area, which we don't have right now. So with that said, thank you for listening and watching this training video on using the search bar to search for severe weather reports on Facebook. Thank you.